Hello students, welcome back to UGC NTA NET revision course series for political science. Topic is Vivekanand. Through this revision course series, you can check your preparation status and you can do the revision in precise and depth manner, because you know that UGC NTA NET always ask the depth knowledge of the candidate. Through the proper revision only, you can attempt all questions correctly. In this video, through the multiple choice questions, I tried to cover all sections related to this topic. After going through this video, you can attempt any questions correctly related to the topic Vivekanand. So be with this video till the end. If you didn't subscribe my channel yet, please subscribe to my channel. Click the bell icon so that you can get the notification of my new videos. Let us start the revision from the first question. First question is, who wrote the book Man, the Maker of His Own Destiny? These are the options: Swami Vivekanand, Mahatma Gandhi, disciple of Vivekanand, Subhash Chandra Bose. First, you do the answer on your own for knowing about the status of your preparation. Then I will give the answer. Did you solve the answer correctly? Now I am giving the correct answer. Answer is disciple of Swami Vivekanand. Publisher of this book was Ramakrishna Vidyasala, and this book was written in English language. Now we will see some important facts about Swami Vivekanand. Swami Vivekanand was born as Narendranath Datta on 12th January 1863. He is considered one of the chief saints of India, the prime disciple of 19th century Indian mystic Ramakrishna Paramahansa. He reintroduced the Indian philosophies of Vedanta and Yoga to the Western world. Now the next question is, who were the parents of Vivekananda? Vishwanath Datta, Bhuvaneshwari Devi, Prabhavati Datta, Janaki Nath Bose. These are the options: A and B, B and C, C and D, A and C. Solve the question first. Okay, now I am giving the correct answer. Option 1 is the correct answer. Vishwanath Datta and Bhuvaneshwari Devi were the parents of Vivekanand. Let us see some facts about his parents and his siblings. Father Vishwanath Datta, attorney at the Calcutta High Court. Mother Bhuvaneshwari Devi, housewife. Brothers Bhupendranath Datta, Mahendranath Datta, and sister Swarna Moyi Devi. Now the question is, what would young Naren call himself while playing with his friends? These are the options: Samrat the King of Kings, Swamiji, Young Mr. Datta, Vile. Do the answer first. The correct option is option A, Samrat the King of Kings. In 1899, Swami Vivekananda started a Bengali journal to carry forward the ideas propounded by the Ramakrishna Mission. It was called Vedanta Kesari Udbodhan Brahmavadin Prabuddha Bharat. Now the correct option is option B, Udbodhan. Udbodhan is the only Bengali publication of the Ramakrishna Math and Ramakrishna Mission started by Vivekananda in January 1899. With Trigunatitananda, pre-monastic name of Sarda Prashannamitra, was a direct disciple of Ramakrishna as its founding editor. Over the years, it also grew into a publishing house and remained one of the leading publishers of literature of Ramakrishna and Vivekananda. Library facilities, reading and lending books are available at Udbodhan office. The collection varies from history, culture, the Vedas, the Upanishads, to adventures. Now the question is, what was the question that Swami Vivekanand asked Sri Ramakrishna at their first meeting? The options are, have you seen God? Do you think God exists? Do you believe in God? Is there a God? Do you know the answer? The correct option is option A, have you seen God? The relationship between Ramakrishna and Vivekananda is one of the most important incidents in Vivekananda's life. With answers, I am also giving you extra informations. Through extra informations, you can make your revision perfect and you can also solve many types of direct as well as indirect questions. Ramakrishna and Vivekananda first met in November 1881 at the house of Surendranath Mitra. Ramakrishna asked Narendranath, the pre-monastic name of Vivekananda, to sing. Impressed by his singing talent, he invited him to Dakshineshwar. Have you seen God? Was the first question. Young Narendranath asked Ramakrishna when he went to meet him at Dakshineshwar. The meeting proved to be a turning point in the life of Narendranath. Initially, Narendra didn't accept Ramakrishna as his master and found him monomaniac, but eventually he became one of the closest people in his life. Ramakrishna reportedly shaped the personality of Narendranath and prepared him to dedicate his life to serve the humanity. After the death of Ramakrishna, Narendra and his other monastic disciples established their first monastery at Baranagar. Ekanathji Ranade founded a non-monastic organization based on the principles preached by Swami Vivekananda. What is it called? These are the options. You have to select correct one. The correct option is option D, Vivekananda Kendra. Vivekananda Kendra is a social organization closely affiliated with the Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh. It was founded by Ekanath Ranade to commemorate the arrival of Swami Vivekanand at the rock at Kanyakumari, where he sat and meditated for 3 days in 1892. Now the question is, Margaret Novel, a disciple of Swami Vivekananda, is well known as? These are the options. You should give the answer fast. The correct option is option D, Sister Nivedita. Now we should also know about the relationship between Sister Nivedita and Vivekananda. Margaret E. Novel, born in Ireland, was converted to Hinduism by Swami Vivekananda with a new name as Sister Nivedita, meaning the offered one. Sister Nivedita met Swami Vivekananda in 1895 in London and travelled to Calcutta in 1898. Vivekananda initiated her into the vow of Brahmacharya on March 25, 1898. Swamiji wanted that under her care, the women of India, especially in Calcutta, be looked after to improve upon their health and education. Through Sister Nivedita, Swami Vivekananda wanted to bring awareness among women about health and education. To introduce Sister Nivedita to the local people in his speech, Swami Vivekananda said, England has sent us another gift in Miss Margaret Novel. Now the question is, which of these ideas did Swami Vivekananda espouse all through his life? These are the options. Have faith in yourself. Never to live a life of secrecy. Living a life of integrity. All the above. Tell the correct answer. Now the correct answer is all the above. Sri Ramakrishna said, if Kesav is possessed of one sign of greatness which has made him famous, Naren has such sign to the fullest degree. The options are 7, 18, 1000, 108. Tell the correct answer now. The correct answer is option B, 18. In which city in US a street is named after Swami Vivekananda? These are the options. You try to give the answer on your own. The correct option is Chicago. On November 11, 1995, a section of Michigan Avenue, one of the most prominent streets in Chicago that passes in front of the Art Institute, was formally renamed Swami Vivekananda Way. This date and the former street name is also important. The Art Institute used a bronze plaque to specifically commemorate Swami Vivekananda's historic 1893 speech in Chicago, because Swami Vivekananda delivered his speech in Art Institute in Chicago. See, this is very easy question. I think you can give the answer very easily. The world's parliament of religions, where Swamiji gave the famous speech on the universality of religions, was held in Chicago in, these are the options, September 1886, September 1893, July 1893, July 1886. Now the correct option is option B, September 1893. This incident proved as the turning point in Vivekananda's life, because after this incident, Vivekananda became as the renowned personality in the entire world. So about this incident, you should know precisely for attempting the direct as well as indirect questions, because UGC frequently asks the indirect questions also for knowing the depth knowledge of the candidate about the topic. September 11 is celebrated by remembering the speech of Swami Vivekananda, which he gave in the Parliament of Religions of Chicago. This speech of Swami Vivekananda won the hearts of the people. Now you should also know about the special things of the speech for attempting the indirect as well as direct questions from this topic. In the beginning of his speech, Swami Vivekananda said, "My brothers and sisters of America." This was a big thing in itself, because everybody expected that Swami Vivekananda would start his speech from "ladies and gentlemen." "I am proud that I am from a country which has kept the persecuted people of all the countries and religions of this earth under shelter." This sentence not only makes our country proud, but also gives respect to the patriotism within us. "I thank you on behalf of the ancient saint tradition of my country. I also thank you on behalf of the mother of all the religions, and express my gratitude on behalf of millions, crores of Hindus from all castes, sects. My thanks to some, even those speakers who told this forum that the idea of tolerance in the world spread from the countries of the Far East." Now the question is, "The Master as I Saw Him" was written by, these are the options. First, you try to give all answers on your own. Evaluate your preparation status. Then do the revision from these questions and the explanation of the answers. If you do the revision in this way, I am assuring you that you will be able to solve any question correctly, no matter question is asked directly or indirectly. Because I saw many times aspirant get confused if question come indirectly, although they know the topic, due to lack of the depth knowledge. So through this kind of revision work, you can get into the topic and you can attempt any question correctly. Now tell the correct option. The correct option is option D. Sister Nivedita, The Master as I Saw Him, is an important book on the life of Swami Vivekananda. You also should know about the important facts of this book for attempting many indirect questions. This book was written by Sister Nivedita. In this book, she shared her experience with Swami Vivekananda, whom she met in London during November 1895. The Master as I Saw Him is now considered to be a classic text. In his book, Indian Traffic, Parama Roy noted that the book differed from the biographies of Vivekananda in that it touched upon the agonistic, conflictual nature of the guru-disciple relationship and showed reticence about his corporeality. Vivekananda is the maker of modern India. Who said this? The options are Rabindranath Tagore, Jawaharlal Nehru, C. Rajagopalachari, and Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. What is the correct answer? Do you know the correct answer? Now the correct answer is option D, Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. During 1888 to 1893, Swami Vivekananda traveled throughout India. Three things were his only companion: Kamandal, Bhagavad Gita, and these are the options. What is the correct answer? Now the correct option is option C, the book Imitation of Christ. Apart from this, you should also know some important facts about the travels of Swami Vivekananda for attempting many indirect questions from this section. He started his travel in 1888 as a Parivrajaka, the Hindu religious life of a wandering monk. His sole possessions were a kamandalu, a staff, and his two favorite books, the Bhagavad Gita and the Imitation of Christ. He traveled for 5 years. During his travels, he met Hindus, Rajas, Muslims, Christians, government officials, etc. He started his travels from north. In August 1888, his first destination was Varanasi, where he visited the places where Gautama Buddha and Adi Shankara preached and met Bengali writer Buddhadev Mukhopadhyay and Hindu saint Trailanga Swami. He also met Sanskrit and Vedic scholar Babu Parmada Das Mitra, with whom he corresponded on the interpretation of Hindu scriptures. These three people are also very important for exam perspective. After meeting Vivekananda, Mukhopadhyay said, "Such vast experience and insight at such an early age, I am sure he will be a great man." After leaving Varanasi, he visited Ayodhya, Lucknow, Agra, Vrindavan, Hathras, and Rishikesh. Now, you should try to frame some supplementary questions from this section for making your preparation perfect. From which direction and place Vivekananda started his travels and in which year? The answer is in August 1888. Swami Vivekananda started his travels from Varanasi in north. Then, which places Narendra Nath visited in Varanasi? Can you give this answer? Narendra Nath visited the places where Gautama Buddha and Adi Shankara preached. With whom Narendra Nath met in Varanasi? Narendra Nath met Bengali writer Buddhadev Mukhopadhyay Hindu Saint Trilanga Swami and Sanskrit and Vedic scholar Babu Parmada Das Mitra. Who said about Vivekananda, such vast experience and insight at such an early age, I am sure he will be a great man. Bengali writer Buddhadev Mukhopadhyay. After leaving Varanasi, which places Vivekananda visited to? After leaving Varanasi, Vivekananda visited Ayodhya, Lucknow, Agra, Vrindavan, Hathras and Rishikesh. On the way to Haridwar in September 1888, Narendra stayed at Hathras where he met Sarat Chandra Gupta, a railway station master in the railway waiting room. Vivekananda called him the child of my spirit. He decided to renounce the world and became a disciple of Narendranath. Narendra and Gupta left Hathras together. Let us discuss some supplementary questions for making your revision perfect and getting the precise and depth knowledge about the topic. Where did Narendranath stay while on the way to Haridwar in September 1888? First, you try to give the answer on your own. Answer is, on the way to Haridwar in September 1888, Narendra stayed at Hathras. Whom did Narendra meet in Hathras and in which place? In the railway waiting room, Narendra meets Sarat Chandra Gupta, a railway station master. After leaving Hathras, Narendra and Gupta visited to which places? After leaving Hathras, Narendra and Gupta first went to Haridwar and from there travelled to Rishikesh on foot. Where Narendra initiated Sarat Chandra Gupta into sannyasa and was named Swami Sadananda. In Rishikesh, Narendra initiated Gupta into sannyasa and was named Swami Sadananda. Whom did Vivekananda call the child of my spirit? The answer is Sarat Chandra Gupta. Now, meeting with Pavahari Baba is one of the most important incidents during Vivekananda's travels. Between 1888 and 1890, Swami Vivekananda visited Vaidyanath in Allahabad. On 18th January 1890, he went from Allahabad to Ghazipur and met Pavahari Baba and Advaita Vedanta ascetic who has spent much of his time in meditation. Initially, he wanted to become his disciple, but before his initiation, Swami Vivekananda had a dream in which Ramakrishna looked at him with a melancholy face. This dream convinced Swami Vivekananda that no one other than Ramakrishna could be his teacher, and he abandoned the idea of becoming Baba's disciple. Let us discuss some important questions for knowing about your preparation status. If you know the answer, then you try to give the answer on your own. When did Swami Vivekananda visit Vaidyanath in Allahabad? Between 1888 and 1890, Swami Vivekananda visited Vaidyanath in Allahabad. Where did Vivekananda meet Pavahari Baba and Advaita Vedanta ascetic who has spent much of his time in meditation and when? On 18th January 1890, Vivekananda went from Allahabad to Ghazipur and met Pavahari Baba. After meeting Pavahari Baba, what relationship Swami Vivekananda wanted to develop with him? After meeting Pavahari Baba, Swami Vivekananda wanted to become his disciple. What convinced Swami Vivekananda that no one other than Ramakrishna could be his teacher and he abandoned the idea of becoming Baba's disciple? A dream the night before Swami Vivekananda's initiation in which Ramakrishna looked at him with a melancholy face made him convinced that no one other than Ramakrishna could be his teacher, and he abandoned the idea of becoming Baba's disciple. During the first half of 1890, after the deaths of fellow Ramakrishna disciples Balarama Bose and Suresh Chandra Mitra, Narendra returned to Baranagar Math because of ill health and to arrange for the Math's financial support. After finishing his work in July, he left the Math and started journey for the Himalayas. This continued the first phase of his journey, which would bring Swami Vivekananda to the West. He visited the sacred sites of Nainital, Almora, Srinagar, Dehradun, Rishikesh and Haridwar. These places you should remember in chronological order. During these travels, he met Swami Brahmananda, Saradananda, Turiyananda and Advaityananda. At the end of January 1891, Swami Vivekananda left his colleagues and travelled to Delhi. Let us discuss some important questions from this section. These all questions will make your preparation concrete. When and why did Narendra return to Baranagar Math in mid of his travels? During the first half of 1890, after the deaths of fellow Ramakrishna disciples Balarama Bose and Suresh Chandra Mitra, Narendra returned to Baranagar Math because of ill health and to arrange for the Math's financial support. When and with whom Vivekananda resumed his travel for throughout India? After finishing his work in July 1890, he left the Math accompanied by fellow monk Swami Akhandananda for the Himalayas. Which sacred sites Vivekananda visited during the travels for Himalayan states? Vivekananda visited the sacred sites of Nainital, Almora, Srinagar, Dehradun, Rishikesh and Haridwar. With whom Vivekananda met during the travels of Himalayan states? During the travels of Himalayan states, Vivekananda met Swami Brahmananda, Saradananda, Turiyananda and Advaityananda. After completing the first phase of his journey, Swami Vivekananda headed to which direction? After completing the first phase of his journey, Swami Vivekananda headed to the west. What steps Vivekananda did during his stay in Meerut? Vivekananda stayed in Meerut for several days, engaged in meditation, prayer and study of the scripture. When did Vivekananda travel to Delhi? At the end of January 1891, Swami Vivekananda left his colleagues and traveled to Delhi. Then he turned to Rajputana. First, I give the information in brief, then through question and answer, I try to sharpen your knowledge as well as preparation status. In February 1891, he first went to Alwar, where he was warmly welcomed by the Hindus and the Muslims. There he told a Muslim religion scholar that one significant feature of the Quran is, though it was written 1,000 years ago, the book was free from interpolation and retained its original purity. When Swami Vivekananda met the Mangal Singh, King of Alwar, whose outlook was westernized, Singh challenged Swami Vivekananda and ridiculed Hindu idol worship. Swami Vivekananda attempted to explain to him that Hindu worship is symbolic worship, but failed to make the king understand. Then Swami Vivekananda saw a painting hanging on the wall. It was the painting of the Singh's deceased father and asked him to spit on it. Singh became angry and retorted how he could spit on his father. Swami Vivekananda explained, though it was just a painting, nor the king himself, it reminds everybody about the king. Similarly, an idol worshipped by a Hindu is actually a symbolic worship of the Supreme. From Alwar, Swami Vivekananda went to Jaipur, where he studied Panini's Ashtadhyayi with a Sanskrit scholar. Swami Vivekananda then went to Ajmer, where he visited the palace of Akbar and the Dargah Sharif. These places and these people are also very important for exam perspective. At Mount Abu, he met Raja Ajit Singh Khetri, who became an ardent devotee and supporter. Swami Tathagatananda, a senior monk in the Ramakrishna order, wrote of their relationship. Vivekananda's friendship with Maharaja Ajit Singh of Khetri was enacted against the backdrop of Khetri, a sanctified town in northern Rajasthan, characterized by its long heroic history and independent spirit. Now we should also know some important facts about Swamiji and Maharaja Ajit Singh friendship. Destiny brought Swamiji and Ajit Singh together on 4th June 1891 at Mount Abu, where their friendship gradually developed through their mutual interest in significant spiritual and secular topics. The friendship intensified when they traveled to Khetri, and it became clear that theirs was the most sacred friendship, that of a guru and his disciple. At Khetri, Swami Vivekananda delivered discourses to the Raja, became acquainted with Pandit Ajada, Adi Bhatla Narayana Dasu, and studied the Mahabhasya on the Sutras of Panini. After 2.5 months there, in October 1891, he left for Maharashtra. Let us discuss the question from this section. When did Vivekananda go to Alwar? In February 1891, he first went to Alwar, where he was warmly welcomed by the Hindus and the Muslims. What did Swami Vivekananda tell a Muslim religion scholar about the significant feature of the Quran? Swami Vivekananda told a Muslim religion scholar that one significant feature of the Quran is, though it was written 1,000 years ago, the book was free from interpolation and retained its original purity. What did Mangal Singh, King of Alwar, challenge Swami Vivekananda? Mangal Singh, King of Alwar, whose outlook was westernized, challenged Swami Vivekananda to prove the significance of idol worship and ridiculed Hindu idol worship, stating that the idols you worship are nothing but piece of clay, stones or metals. What is the next question? How did Swami Vivekananda make Mangal Singh convinced about the significance of idol worship? Swami Vivekananda asked Mangal Singh to spit the painting of his deceased father. Singh became angry and retorted how he could spit on his father. Swami Vivekananda explained, though it was just a painting, not the king himself, it reminds everybody about the king. Similarly, an idol worshipped by a Hindu is actually a symbolic worship of the Supreme. Where did Swami Vivekananda study Panini's Ashtadhyayi? From Alwar, Swami Vivekananda went to Jaipur, where he studied Panini's Ashtadhyayi with a Sanskrit scholar. Swami Vivekananda visited which places in Ajmer? From Jaipur, Swami Vivekananda went to Ajmer, where he visited the palace of Akbar and Dargah Sharif. Whom did Swami Vivekananda meet at Mount Abu? At Mount Abu, Swami Vivekananda met Raja Ajit Singh of Khetri, who became an ardent devotee and supporter. The next question is, what did Swami Tathagatananda, a senior monk in the Ramakrishna order, wrote about the relationship between Vivekananda and Maharaja Ajit Singh of Khetri? He wrote Vivekananda's friendship with Maharaja Ajit Singh of Khetri was enacted against the backdrop of Khetri, a sanctified town in northern Rajasthan, characterized by its long heroic history and independent spirit. How did the relationship between Narendranath and Maharaja Ajit Singh of Khetri develop? Destiny brought Swamiji and Ajit Singh together on 4th June 1891 at Mount Abu, where their friendship gradually developed through their mutual interest in significant spiritual and secular topics. The friendship intensified when they traveled to Khetri, and it became clear that theirs was the most sacred friendship, that of a guru and his disciple. Let us see the next questions. What steps Swami Vivekananda did at Khetri? At Khetri, Swami Vivekananda delivered discourses to the Raja, became acquainted with Pandit Ajada Adi Bhatla, Narayana Dasu, and studied the Mahabhasya on the Sutras of Panini. When did Vivekananda leave for Maharashtra? After staying for 2.5 months at Khetri, Vivekananda left for Maharashtra. Now, Vivekananda moved to west direction. Swami Vivekananda visited Ahmedabad, Badwan, and Limbadi at the former. He completed his studies of Islamic and Jain cultures. At Limbadi, he met Thakur Sahib Jaswant Singh, who had been to England and America. From him, Narendra first got the idea of going to the west to preach Vedanta. He visited Junagadh and was the guest of Haridas Bihari Das Desai, Diwan of the state, who was so charmed by his company that every evening he and all the state officials conversed with Swami Vivekananda until late at night. Swami Vivekananda also visited Girnar, Kutch, Porbandar, Dwarka, Palitana, Nadiadni Haveli, and Baroda. He remained for 9 months at Porbandar, furthering his philosophical and Sanskrit studies with learned pandits. Swami Vivekananda's next destinations included Mahabaleshwar, Pune, Khandwa, and Indore. These facts are very important for exam perspective. At Kathiawar, he heard of the 1893 Parliament of the World's Religions and was urged by his followers to attend it. After a brief stay in Mumbai in July 1892, he met Bal Gangadhar Tilak during a train journey. After staying with Tilak for a few days in Pune, Swami Vivekananda travelled to Belgaum in October 1892, where he met Pant Maharaj and Tupanaji and Margaon in Goa. Spending 3 days at Rakol Seminary, the oldest convent in Goa, with rare religious manuscripts and printed works in Latin, studying Christian theological works. Now, the time to solve the question. Which places Swami Vivekananda visited in West in the initial phase of his journey to the West? Swami Vivekananda visited Ahmedabad, Badwan, and Limbadi at the former. He completed his studies of Islamic and Jain cultures. From whom Narendra first got the idea of going to the West to preach Vedanta? At Limbadi, he met Thakur Sahib Jaswant Singh, who had been to England and America. From him, Narendra first got the idea of going to the West to preach Vedanta. In Judangarh, Swami Vivekananda was the guest of whom? In Junagadh, he was the guest of Haridas Bihari Das Desai, Diwan of the state, who was so charmed by his company that every evening he and all the state officials conversed with Swami Vivekananda until late at night. After Junagadh, Swami Vivekananda visited to which places in Gujarat? After Junagadh, Swami Vivekananda visited Girnar, Kutch, Porbandar, Dwarka, Palitana, Nadiad, Nadiadni Haveli, and Baroda in Gujarat. How long Vivekananda remained at Porbandar? Vivekananda remained for 9 months at Porbandar, furthering his philosophical and Sanskrit studies with learned pandits. After visiting Porbandar, Swami Vivekananda visited to which place? After visiting Porbandar, Swami Vivekananda visited Mahabaleshwar, Pune, Khandwa, and Indore. Where did Vivekananda heard of the 1893 Parliament of the World's Religions? At Kathiawar, he heard of the 1893 Parliament of the World Religions and was urged by his followers to attend it. Next question is, where did Swami Vivekananda meet Bal Gangadhar Tilak? After a brief stay in Mumbai in July 1892, he met Bal Gangadhar Tilak during a train journey. After visiting Pune, Swami Vivekananda traveled to which places and met whom? After staying with Tilak for a few days in Pune, Swami Vivekananda traveled to Belgaum in October 1892, where he met Pant Maharaj and to Panaji and Margaon in Goa. Where and how long did Swami Vivekananda stay in Goa and what did he study there? Swami Vivekananda spent 3 days at Rakul Seminary, the oldest convent in Goa, and studied Christian theological works with rare religious manuscripts and printed works in Latin. Now we will see the travel of Vivekananda to the south direction. Then we will solve the questions related to this. Swami Vivekananda later traveled to Bangalore, where he became acquainted with Sasadri Iyer, Diwan of the Mysore state. Iyer described Narendra as a magnetic personality and the divine force which were destined to leave their mark on the history of his country. Iyer introduced him to Maharaja of Mysore, Chamaraja Wodeyar. Wodeyar invited Swami Vivekananda to stay in his palace as a guest. The Maharaja gave Swami Vivekananda a letter of introduction to the Diwan of Cochin and a railway ticket. From Bangalore, Swami Vivekananda visited Thrissur, Kodungallur, and Ernakulam. At Ernakulam, he met Chattampi Swamikal, a contemporary of Narayana Guru, in early December 1892. From Ernakulam, Swami Vivekananda travelled to Trivandrum, Nagarkoli, and reached Kanyakumari on foot on Christmas Eve 1892. At Kanyakumari, Swami Vivekananda meditated on the last bit of Indian rock, later known as the Vivekananda Rock Memorial. At Kanyakumari, Narendra had a vision of one India. He later wrote, "At Cape Camorin, sitting in Mother Kumari's temple, sitting on the last bit of Indian rock, I hit upon a plan. We are so many sannyasis wandering about and teaching the people metaphysics, it is all madness. Did not our Gurudev used to say, an empty stomach is no good for religion? We as a nation have lost our individuality, and that is the cause of all mischief in India. We have to raise the masses. To realize this, he needed collaborators and funds. The people were easy to find, but the funds were hard to acquire. And therefore, Narendra decided to travel to America to earn money myself and then return to my country and devote the rest of my days to the realization of this one aim of my life. From Kanyakumari, Swami Vivekananda visited Madurai and had meetings with the Raja of Ramnath, Bhaskara Setupathi. During his meetings, he had extensive discussions on Hindu philosophy with eminent scholars like Mahavidwan or Raghava Iyengar. The Raja became his disciple, urging him to attend the Parliament of Religions in Chicago. From Madurai, Swami Vivekananda visited Rameswaram, Pondicherry, and Madras. There he met some of his disciples, especially Ala Singha Perumal. Perumal went door to door in hopes of getting money for Swami Vivekananda's travel. With funds collected by his Madras disciples, the King of Mysore, Ramanand, Khetri, Divans, and other followers, Swami Vivekananda left Mumbai for Chicago on 31st May 1893 with the name Vivekananda, as suggested by Ajit Singh of Khetri, which means the bliss of discerning wisdom. Now the questions are, with whom Swami Vivekananda became acquainted with in Bangalore? Swami Vivekananda became acquainted with K. Sasadri Iyer, Diwan of the Mysore estate in Bangalore. How did K. Sasadri Iyer describe Narendra? K. Sasadri Iyer described Narendra as a magnetic personality and a divine force which were destined to leave their mark on the history of his country. With whom Vivekananda was introduced by K. Sasadri Iyer? K. Sasadri Iyer introduced Vivekananda to the Maharaja, King of Mysore, Chamaraja Wodeyar. How did the Maharaja, King of Mysore, Chamaraja Wodeyar welcome Swami Vivekananda? Wodeyar invited Swami Vivekananda to stay in his palace as a guest and gave Swami Vivekananda a letter of introduction to the Diwan of Cochin and a railway ticket. From Bangalore, Swami Vivekananda visited to which places? From Bangalore, Swami Vivekananda visited Thrissur, Kodungallur, and Innakulam. Next question is, whom did Vivekananda meet at Innakulam? At Innakulam, Vivekananda met Chattampi Swamikal, a contemporary of Narayana Guru, in early December 1892. From Ernakulam, Swami Vivekananda travelled to which places? From Ernakulam, Swami Vivekananda travelled to Trivandrum, Nagarkoli, and reached Kanyakumari on foot on Christmas Eve 1892. Where did Swami Vivekananda meditate at Kanyakumari? At Kanyakumari, Swami Vivekananda meditated on the last bit of Indian rock, later known as the Vivekananda Rock Memorial. What was the Kanyakumari Resolve of 1892? The Kanyakumari Resolve of 1892 was the resolution taken by Indian Hindu monk Swami Vivekananda to dedicate himself for the service and the welfare of people, In 1970, Vivekananda Rock Memorial was founded at the place where Vivekananda took his resolution. Next question is, what vision Narendra had at Kanyakumari? At Kanyakumari, Narendra had a vision of one India. Whom did Vivekananda meet in Madurai? From Kanyakumari, Swami Vivekananda visited Madurai and had meeting with the Raja of Ramnad, Bhaskara Setupathi, with whom Vivekananda had extensive discussion during his meetings with the Raja of Ramnad, Bhaskara Setupathi. During his meeting, he had extensive discussions on Hindu philosophy with eminent scholars like Mahavidwan R. Raghava Iyengar. Now the next question is, who asked Vivekananda to attend the Parliament of Religions in Chicago? The Raja of Ramnad became Vivekananda's disciples and asked him to attend the Parliament of Religions in Chicago. From Madurai, Swami Vivekananda visited to which places and meet whom? From Madurai, Swami Vivekananda visited Rameswaram, Pondicherry and Madras. There he met some of his disciples, especially Alasinga Perumal, who went door to door in hopes of getting money for Swami Vivekananda's travel. Perumal went door to door in hopes of getting money for Swami Vivekananda's travels. Next question is, who gave letters of introduction to chairman of the committee for selection of delegates in the Parliament of Religions for Swami Vivekananda? Answer is Professor J.S. Wright. How did Swami Vivekananda went for Chicago on 31st May 1893? With funds collected by his Madras disciples, the King of Mysore, Ramnath, Khetri, Divans and other followers, Swami Vivekananda left Mumbai for Chicago on 31st May 1893. Who suggested Narendranath to change his name as Vivekananda while going to attend the World Parliament of Religions in Chicago? Narendranath attended the World Parliament of Religions in Chicago with the name Vivekananda as suggested by Ajit Singh of Khetri, which means the bliss of discerning wisdom. Let us discuss some miscellaneous questions. Swami Vivekananda was born in Kolkata on 12th January 1863. His birthday in India is celebrated as, options are National Day of Service, National Spiritual Day, National Youth Day, National Meditation Day. What is the answer? This question has been asked many times in exam. Now the correct option is option C, National Youth Day. Now we should also know some important facts about National Youth Day for attempting many indirect questions. National Youth Day, also known as Vivekananda Jayanti, is celebrated on 12th January, being the birthday of Swami Vivekananda. In 1984, the Government of India declared this day as National Youth Day, and since 1985, the event is celebrated in India every year. The main objective behind the celebration is to propagate the philosophy and the ideas of Swami Vivekananda, for which he lived and worked. Now the question is, who said about Swami Vivekananda, "Vivekananda saved Hinduism, saved India"? These are the options. You have to select correct one. The correct option is option B, C. Rajagopalachari. Vivekananda Rock was inaugurated in 1972. Who was primarily responsible to get the public support and financing for building it? These are the options. You have to select correct option. करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन सी, एकनाथ रानाडे. नाउ द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज नेम द स्पेशल ट्रेन लॉन्च्ड बाय द इंडियन रेलवेज टू कोमेमोरेट द 150th बर्थ एनिवर्सरी ऑफ स्वामी विवेकानंद एंड क्रिएट अवेयरनेस अमंग द मासेस अबाउट हिज थॉट्स एंड फिलोसफी. दीज आर द ऑप्शंस, विवेकानंद एक्सप्रेस, विवेक एक्सप्रेस, Narendra Express, Amrita Express. What is the correct option? The correct option is option B, Vivek Express. Now the question is, who spearheaded the building of the Vivekananda Memorial at Kanyakumari? These are the options. You have to select correct one. The correct option is option A, Eknath Ranade. In 1898, while at Almora, Swamiji received the news of the sad demise of three persons he loved very much. Who were they? These are the options. The correct option is option D, Mr. Goodwin, Saint Pavahari Baba and Rajam Iyer. Next question is, what is the motto of Ramakrishna Mission? Answer is, At Mano Mokshartham Jagat Hitaya. Let us discuss some miscellaneous questions. Vivekananda translated Herbert Spencer's book, Education, into which language? Answer is Bengali. What did Vivekananda learn while studying Western philosopher? While studying Western philosopher, he also learned Sanskrit scriptures and Bengali literature. What did William Hastie write about Vivekananda? William Hastie, the principal of Christian College, Calcutta, from where Narendra graduated, wrote about him. Narendra is really a genius. I have traveled far and wide, but I have never come across a lad of his talents and possibilities, even in German universities, among philosophical students. He is born to make his mark in life. Now the next question is, when did Narendra join Nava Vidhan? In 1880, Narendra joined Keshav Chandra Sen's Nava Vidhan, which was established by Sen after meeting Ramakrishna and reconverting from Christianity to Hinduism. When did Narendra become a member of Freemasonry Lodge? Narendra became a member of Freemasonry Lodge at some point before 1884. When did Vivekananda join Sadharan Brahma Samaj? Vivekananda joined the Sadharan Brahma Samaj in his 20s. A breakaway faction of the Brahma Samaj led by Keshav Chandra Sen and Devendranath Tagore. During which year Vivekananda was active in Sen's Band of Hope? From 1881 to 1884, he was active in Sen's Band of Hope, which tried to discourage youths from smoking and drinking. Now the next question is, Vivekananda was more influenced by the which organization than by Ramakrishna? Answer is, Vivekananda was more influenced by the Brahmo Samaj and its new ideas than by Ramakrishna. I am giving the answer in one sentence and two sentences so that you can attempt any questions related to Vivekananda's topic, direct as well as indirect questions. Whose influence brought Vivekananda fully into contact with Western esotericism? It was Keshav Chandra Sen's influence who brought Vivekananda fully into contact with Western esotericism. How did Vivekananda meet Ramakrishna? Keshav Chandra Sen made him meet Ramakrishna. How did Narendra's first introduction to Ramakrishna take place? Narendra's first introduction to Ramakrishna occurred in a literature class at General Assembly's institution when he heard Professor William Hastie lecturing on William Wordsworth's poem, The Excursion. While explaining the word trance in the poem, Hastie suggested that his students visit Ramakrishna of Dakshineshwar to understand the true meaning of trance. This prompted some of his students, including Narendra, to visit Ramakrishna. Now, when was the first time Vivekananda met Ramakrishna? These are the options. I think you know the correct option. Okay, I am giving the correct option. Option A, November 1881. While Swami Vivekananda was sitting hungry in the playground in Chicago, who among the following had asked him if he is the one who is delegate to the Conference of World Religions and then offered him to have bath and food at his her house? These are the options. The correct option is option A, Mrs. George Hales. Now the question is, who among the following was considered as mental daughter of Swami Vivekananda? These are the options. The answer is option C, Sister Nivedita. Now the next question is, I prayed to Shiva for a son and he has sent me one of his demons. Who said this about Vivekananda? Vivekananda's mother. Which Sanskrit grammar by Hurted almost whole at the age of 7 by Swami Vivekananda? Answer is Mugdha Bodha. In which year movie based on Vivekananda's life was released? The movie based on Vivekananda's life, Swami Vivekananda, was released in 1998 and The Light Vivekananda in 2013. In which college Narendranath first studied? Answer is Presidency College, Calcutta. In which hall the first session of the Chicago Parliament of Religions was opened? The Great Hall of Columbus. Now, biography of Vivekananda is also very important for exam perspective. Swami Vivekananda and Modern India, written by Swami Jagdishwarananda, was first published in 1941. In this book, the author covered the biography of Vivekananda in brief. Swami Nikhilananda wrote Vivekananda, a biography, which was first published in 1943 from Advaita Ashrama. Yugnayak Vivekananda in Bengali, written by Swami Gambhirananda, was first published in 1966-1967. These biographical books should be remembered in chronological order. Now, books of Vivekananda is also very important. Some book published in his lifetime and some posthumously. Karma Yoga, 1896, Raj Yoga, 1896, Vedanta Philosophy and Address Before the Graduate Philosophical Society, first published 1896, Lectures from Colombo to Almora, 1897, Vedanta Philosophy Lectures on Jana Yoga, 1902. Now we should also know some important books which was published posthumously. Address on Bhakti Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, Complete Works Volume 5, The East and the West, Inspired Talks, Narada Bhakti Sutras, Lectures from Colombo to Almora, Para Bhakti or Supreme Devotion, Practical Vedanta, Speeches and Writings of Swami Vivekananda, a comprehensive collection. Vivekvani in Telugu, Yoga in Telugu, A Banquet of Swami Vivekananda's Writing. It is handwritten works of Swami Vivekananda. It was published in 2013. Now you see some important quotes of Vivekananda. These quotes are also very important for exam perspective. Please like, share, and subscribe.